Let's have a look at the Daily Mail. We've got Harry's hacking claim.
Yeah, so Harry's hacking claim has been thrown out by the court. So this is apparently because it breached the sort of statute of limitations.
Right.
There's a clandestine deal, according to Prince Harry, or the Duke of Sussex, whatever he's called now, the artist formerly known as Prince. He claimed that there's a clandestine deal between palace courtiers and how do you pronounce that? And people who work at the palace and newspaper executives. And that was the reason he didn't bring his case sooner. So this deal was struck in 2012, so he didn't, you know, do anything about phone hacking since then. But then, you know, by law, claimants have 6 years within which to pursue the action.
Yeah, OK. So it's all been, it's been deemed like a wild conspiracy theory, essentially, that he's crazy, or almost. Is that what they're saying? That it's implausible that the Queen had this kind of set-up?
Yeah, and the judge ruled it implausible. That was the specific word.
So what, he's just filed his claim too late?
Yeah.
He's probably just got ADHD, so I'll leave it to the last minute. And then.
It's very hard to tell these things. I know I'm my memory is, you know, my memories don't shuffle along the conveyor belt quite as smoothly as they used to. How long has Harry been in this kind of world of pain? I can't remember. Is it 6 years since he's been with Meghan? And I mean, how long ago was it that he was happily attending fancy dress parties in Nazi safari gear and stuff?
He was like 19 or something.
It's a long time ago.
He seemed happy when he married Meghan because they hadn't sort of fallen out with the media then.
Mm. Yeah.
Or hadn't. I mean, to be honest, the pair of them looked like they could start a fight in an empty room, you know what I mean?